So you've had to say goodbye to the sports car because a family has arrived. And now you're looking for a luxury, perhaps three-row crossover SUV. But you don't want to let go of that sporty driving experience that your old sports car used to give you. So what do? Well, Mercedes-Benz thinks that they have the solution for you, and it's this GLB 35 AMG. So is it any good? Well, let's go for a drive and find out. Under the hood of this Mercedes GLB 35 AMG is predictably a 2-liter turbocharged engine. This engine produces 302 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of torque. That's good enough for a 0 to 100 kilometer an hour time of 5.2 seconds, as Mercedes-Benz estimates. From behind the steering wheel, it actually does feel like that. You really get that nice surge in acceleration when you put your foot down. And even though this GLB weighs at 1,755 kilograms, it's still really quick for what it is. Also, unlike its 45 brother, the more powerful version of this engine, it doesn't have that high of a boost threshold and very little in the way of turbo lag. So what I mean by that is if you put your foot down at around 2,000 RPMs or higher and you don't let the transmission downshift, you get a nice surge in acceleration, but anywhere below 2000 RPMs and you're not really going to go anywhere unless you let this 8-speed dual clutch automatic downshift. Speaking of which, this transmission is pretty good for the most part. It's not perfect, but it's pretty good for what it is. On the move, the shifts are pretty much imperceivable. They are that smooth. Of course, in comfort mode and as long as you're driving like a normal person. If you put your foot down, the transmission reacts instantly, like so, and you do feel those shifts a little bit more, but they're still incredibly quick and relatively smooth. The only times that this transmission doesn't really do as you expect it to do is when you're setting off from a stop. At times it kind of feels a little bit, how can I put this, hesitant to engage the clutch. Other times it engages it really quickly and you accelerate a bit more quickly than you anticipated. But overall, the transmission is pretty good and it aids the engine in achieving some pretty okay fuel economy numbers. Officially, it is rated for 8.9 liters per 100 kilometers on a highway and 11.1 liters per 100 kilometers in a city. Currently, I'm averaging about 10.7 liters per 100 kilometers. It keeps fluctuating between those numbers. So you can definitely achieve those fuel economy targets. Stopping this GLB 35 are four piston fixed calipers on the front and a single piston floating rear caliper. And you know what? They stop this car very well, like pretty much on a dime. As soon as you put your foot on the brake, yeah, you're really stopping. Better yet, the brake pedal isn't overly sensitive, so you can modulate it to a point where you can arrive at stops very smoothly. In terms of handling, this GLB receives more chassis bracing, and it has different suspension components in the front, as well as adaptive dampers. The end result is it doesn't really lean into corners quite as much as its GLB 250 counterpart. And it sits lower down, so if you're expecting a SUV high driving position in this GLB 35, This isn't the crossover SUV you should be looking at. But when you do take it around a corner, this is a lot of fun for what it is. Steering is incredibly sharp, and it also has some really nice weight to it, so it doesn't feel overly assisted and it doesn't feel too light. It still is easy to maneuver around parking lots, but on a twisty road, it makes much more sense than, like I said, the GLB 250, for example. With the GLB being a more entry-level Mercedes-Benz vehicle, the amount of noise intruding into the cabin is a bit more than in the GLC, for example, or a GLE. Driving over bumps, you notice quite a bit of noise coming from the B pillars and the C pillars, like the trim pieces on those pillars. As well, this particular demo vehicle sits on 21-inch wheels and tires, so on highways, there's a lot of road noise. You can drown out a little bit of that noise with the engine noise if you put your foot down, but it doesn't sound quite as throaty and as muscular as its 45 brother. That one had a dual mode exhaust, so you can make it quiet or loud. This one doesn't have that. It's either quiet at low RPMs, or if you put it into Sport Plus and you put your foot down, then it becomes a little bit louder, but it's not quite the same as the GLA 45, for example. As for the ride, it is a little bit firmer than the GLB 250. Well, of course it is, because this is a more sporty version of that, so you would expect it to be a bit firmer, but in comfort mode with this adaptive suspension, it's not unbearable. You can still do daily commutes without feeling like as though your back is gonna ache by the time you get home. So what about interior space then? Well, the GLB is on the smaller side of the Mercedes SUV family, but on the inside, there's still quite a lot of space up here in the front. 6'4" of me, headroom, legroom, no problems whatsoever. Let's go sit in the back. Back here, it's actually not that bad. There's a bit less headroom compared to the front because this bench sits a bit higher up than the front seats do. And in terms of legroom, my knees are gently brushing up against the back of the front seat in my driving position. But you know what? I'd be okay to sit back here for a road trip. The only thing is, these bottom cushions are a little on the firm side. I prefer it if they were a bit softer. However, you can slide the seats forwards and backwards, and they also recline. Individually, of course. Let's go see the trunk. And back here is where you would find the third row of the GLB 35, but unfortunately this demo vehicle does not have that option equipped. However, if you're as tall as myself, you definitely don't want to be in this third row, because Mercedes-Benz themselves say that it's only meant for kids or adults that are under 5'6". But without it, you have about 633 liters of cargo volume with the second row seats up, and fold those down and you'll have about 1,755 liters of cargo volume. Not bad. So by now you're probably thinking, the GLB 35 is not that bad. Small price to pay for the amount of noise that gets into the interior, but 300 horsepower and a pretty spacious cabin, not bad. How much is it? Well, it starts at $57,500 Canadian, which is a pretty reasonable starting price for what you're getting. However, then you have to go to the options list, and that's where things get expensive. If you want a metallic paint, that's going to be $900 Canadian. If you want the technology package, $1,600 Canadian. The AMG night package is $1,000. If you want leather seats, that's $2,000 Canadian. However, this particular demo vehicle does have the leather seats, and I have to say, the leather is quite coarse. It's not smooth to the touch and not as soft as I would expect it to be. However, it is better than the Artico fake synthetic leather that the base GLB35 gets. If you want these seats to be ventilated, that's $1,200 Canadian. If you want that third row, it's $1,300 Canadian. The premium package is $3,900, although I would recommend that you get it because it has a lot of convenience features like keyless entry, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, so it's definitely a must for the GLB35. If you want navigation, $1,000. The head-up display, $1,500. The garage door openers, $300. If you want the advanced driver assistance package, $1,700. AMG driver's package, $2,000. And if you want the 360 cameras, $650 Canadian. However, like I said, all that you really need is just the premium package. Everything else is just extra garnish that, quite frankly, you can probably do without. So what about looks then? Well, the interior of the GLB35 AMG looks pretty much the same as all other entry-level Mercedes-Benz vehicles. Same dual 10.25-inch displays, same round air vents, same touchpad and quick access buttons, and same Russian nightclub ambient lighting system. On the outside, it looks pretty much the same as the GLB250, but with a few go-faster bits added on. The 35 receives the AMG Panamericana grille, a slightly lower ride height, a small roof spoiler, a rear diffuser that doesn't really diffuse anything, and round exhaust pipes. Coupled with the 21-inch wheels, the GLB35 is a bit of a head-turner to some, but it doesn't scream for attention. So in the end, should you consider the Mercedes-Benz GLB35 AMG? If you do have a child or two on the way and you still want to have that fun weekend drive on a twisty mountain road, this should be right up there on your list of crossovers to look at. But like I said, all you really need is the premium package and perhaps heated or ventilated seats, depending on which part of the United States you live in. Heated seats are standard here in the frigid north of Canada. If you want to know more about the 2021 Mercedes-Benz GLB35 AMG, I wrote a more detailed review of it over on my website. You can find that link in the video description. And as always, I will see you in the next car or truck or most likely another SUV. Anyway, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and see you in the next video.